Hey, welcome back once again to Jack's Tech Corner. This is another Windows Server 2008 training video. Now, before we get started, I wanted to make it very clear to you that if you go to jackstechcorner.com, I still have that Windows Server 2008 R2 training DVD available for sale for you. So if you're serious about learning Windows Server 2008, then this would be the great DVD to get you well on your way from installing to all the configurations you need to do, understanding DNS, DHCP, and all that great stuff that makes a Windows Server. You can just learn it. It's very easy. It's a very self-paced lessons. And for $60, it's very inexpensive to figure out follow along with those videos, and very inexpensive. Also, if you didn't realize it, you can go to onlineclass.jackstechcorner.com and take the online Windows Server 2008 class. Now, if you take this at a college, some colleges are charging $1,000 for a day. One day seminar can be $1,000 to learn Windows Server 2008. Now, what I'm doing is I'm enabling you to learn this at your own pace and get all those great lessons. And then at the end, you actually get a certificate issued by myself. And I would also give you a letter of reference if you would need one, saying that you understand and that you've learned Windows Server 2008 and you're ready to go into the corporate world. So for $150, that's even a special offer right now. Special limited time offer. I took $50 off the normal price of $200 to get you guys and girls out there started with Windows Server 2008. So that's it. I just wanted to show those and make it very clear that they're there for you. I think people often wonder about, well, Jack, what would that be, a certificate from you? I have 25 years of experience, and the certificate is very nice, and it's saying that you completed a standard course to learn Windows Server 2008 R2. So it's very, very, very worthwhile to have that certificate. But if not, like I said, get the DVD, get the same lessons without any of the quizzes or anything. So there you go with that. So what are we going to learn with this lesson on Windows Server 2008? Well, I've been receiving a ton of emails from people saying, Jack, we want to do remote desktop. Well, that's what it's referred to as now. It used to be called Terminal Services, but they don't call it Terminal Services any longer. Since the surfacing of Windows Server 2008, it's been renamed to Windows Desktop. Now, here is the way Windows Desktop works. And I emailed a few of you back and I said, look, this is what you need to know. You can, first of all, have two people using your Windows Server with Remote Desktop. It's called the administrator login, basically. So two different administrators can actually log on to the Windows Server at the same time and never see what the other one's doing. And you can also use that if you're trying to launch an application remotely. It will work. Now, when the third person goes to log in, it's going to tell you that all the licenses are currently in use and you have to wait until another administrator logs off. So you have to purchase what is known as a CAL, or a client access license. Once you buy that client access license, then you load those onto your server, and then you can have, you know, whatever you buy, 5 people on it, 10 people on it, 20, 25. We purchased 25, and our server's handling 25 remote desktop connections absolutely fine with no problem. Now, to get you started in this, once it's installed, Windows Server automatically installs Windows Desktop. It's just a matter of, is it turned on or not? So click the Start button, go to Computer, right-click on Computer, and go to Properties. Now, once you're in Properties, look at Remote Settings. Here's your Remote Settings. Now it says, don't allow connections to this computer if you absolutely don't want remote connections to your computer. Well, that'd be tough with ours because we virtualized all of our servers. So if we couldn't remote into them, the only way to get into them would be through vSphere, which is a whole nother lesson. You don't need to worry about that. What I like to do is click on this one. Allow connections from computers running any version of remote desktops. It's less secure, but then if you have a Mac client or if you have a Windows XP client, or Windows, maybe a Windows 2000 desktop professional, if you have that, all of those can go in and connect in. You don't need Windows 7 to work with this. Now, if everything in your whole entire network is Windows 7, you're absolutely sure and everything is running and you're happy with it, you can also do the allow connections only from computers running remote desktop with network level authentication. Totally up to you how you want to run it. I suggest do the less secure. It's fine. You still need a username and password. Not a big deal. Now, once you select that, anybody you want to let on the server through remote desktop, you are going to have to select users and add them right here. Okay, now Joe the Builder has access to the remote desktop. So click OK. And then click OK again. Now we can go to our Windows XP machine or our Windows 7 machine, and we can set it up so we can take remote desktop and log in with that user's account and run everything from our server. And that's what a lot of you have been asking about. Now, you've also been asking about, Jack, how do I set up the remote desktop client on the computer? Now, the way we do that is very, very simple. All you have to do is right-click on the application. We're going to use this PageBreeze I loaded on this server. Go to Properties, and we have to make a note of the target to launch the program. And then the start in path would be the same path right here up to where the exe is, would be your start in. You make note of that, and then you go ahead and put that on your Windows 7 or your Windows XP machines. Now, if you'd like to see that part of it, what I would suggest you do is either you could take the online course or pick up the DVD, and we're going to go into that part, and we can do that across the DVD. Or you can also email me. What I've been doing lately is if you email me, I can work on your servers remotely. We have remote access control here, so I can work on your server remotely. And we'll talk about the fees for that also. But that's how you would do it. That's how what remote desktop is. That's how you set up. That's how you get permissions into it, and you're good to go. Once you're done, just close everything out, and you're good. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video edition of Remote Desktop and how to set that up and get that rolling for your users. Remote Desktop is going to save you a lot of time. We use it. We use it basically for clients. We use what's called a hard driveless client or driveless client on the client side, and as soon as they turn those on, they basically come up as a remote session into our servers, and then they don't need a desktop computer. Most of your users have no need for a desktop computer. So if I want to upgrade Microsoft Office, I upgrade on our server and everybody has it. Wow, what a great thing to be able to do. Okay, folks, well, until next time, as always, keep those servers running and always check back here for new videos, and I'm sure I can help you out along the way. So don't forget my website, jackstechcorner.com, and check out those DVDs and that class today. I'll see you back here next time on Windows Server 2008. Bye for now.